Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back. I'm Rick Goodale, Public Information Officer for the Gastonia Police Department. I am joined once again by everybody's favorite fire department PIO, Jim Landis. How you doing, Jim?
Good, Rick. How are you?
Great. Did you have a great Halloween?
I did.
Did you dress up?
I'm wearing it.
Why does that not surprise me? Well, now that Halloween's over, I got some bad news for you, Jim.
What's that?
Winter is coming.
And that means that we are rapidly losing daylight. And this Sunday at 2 a.m. will mark the end of daylight savings time. So what that means is that the daylight during the evening rush hour is going to start looking like this.
What just happened?
We just lost an hour of daylight.
Can you bring it back?
Sorry, buddy. You are going to have to wait until March.
Well, what happens if I do this?
Come on, man. I'm trying to do a safety video about the time change here.
Fine. I'll bring it back when I do my safety tips.
That's fine. Can I go ahead and continue on?
Yes.
All right. Thank you. So, when the time change happens, don't be surprised if you feel a little sluggish for a week or two until your body adjusts. That's normal. It happens to everybody. And with the increase of darkness around the time of rush hour, studies have shown that pedestrians who are out and about at dusk are three times more likely to be struck by a car. So pedestrians, these safety tips are really for you, but we also have some in for drivers. But pedestrians, we really need you to be careful when you're out walking and out and about walking around during the dusk hours here.
I'm walking here.
Make sure that you're not playing on your phone, you're not texting, you're not playing games, whatever as you're walking. If you got earbuds in, make sure you take at least one out so you can hear the traffic around you. And as you're about to cross the street or as you're crossing the street, make sure you're making eye contact with all the drivers around you so that you see them and that they see you and that we can keep everybody safe. Drivers, one thing you're going to have to deal with this time change is in the morning, the sun's going to be coming up earlier, so you may have to deal with some really harsh sun glare coming in the mornings on your morning commute. So just be ready for that, and we just want to keep everybody safe. Jim, now that we got these time change safety tips out of the way, we did have some viewers send us some questions. They had some questions about how to change the time on some of their devices, so you feel like answering some questions?
Sure.
All right, so first one came in. Jim, let's see, what do we got here? How do I change the time on my car radio?
It's not worth it. Wait till March.
Okay. Jim, how do I change the time on my microwave and oven?
Probably need an advanced degree in electrical engineering for that one.
Yeah, I have never been able to change the time on my microwave
right.
or oven. Never. All right, Jim, this should be pretty easy. How do I change the time on my phone?
Let Siri do it.
That's true. Okay. And then I don't know who sent this one in, but somebody says, Jim, I still use an hourglass tell time. How do I set an hourglass back 1 hour?
Get a smartphone.
All right, that makes a lot of sense. Okay. All right, so now that we got that out of the way, Jim, I believe you have some winter fire safety tips for us.
I do.
Oh, all right. I see what you did there. All right, nice. I see. Hold on. Just want to see what it looks like on your side. Okay, all right, go ahead.
For one thing, we want to check your smoke alarms and make sure the battery's working or swap out the battery. Make sure your fire extinguisher is in the green. As it gets cooler weather, we're going to start heating. So make sure that if you're using space heaters, you keep them 3 feet away from anything that can burn. Also have your home heating system checked out by a professional person that can do it. And also let's make sure that when we're cooking this fall, let's keep the kids away from the stove.
All right. That's all great advice, and we just want to make sure everybody is safe. So enjoy the lack of daylight,
exactly.
Or not. I hate losing daylight.
Cooler weather.
I don't like the cooler weather, which is one reason why I moved down here, because I wanted to get away from the cooler weather. All right, so everybody stay safe, and we will
see you
next time.